Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel AJ Electrical. My name is James Kutty Thomas, retired electrical inspector from Kerala. Today the topic of the video is earthing configuration. We covered some basics about earthing configuration in the first video. If you are watching directly this video, I request you to go to the first video fully, then only you will get a clear picture what we discussed so far. Today I will be continuing with a few basic terms, then we can enter into TN system and then its subdivisions. Okay, let us move to the topic. As a continuation of our first video, now just let us see what is earth fault loop impedance. You can see on diagram here. See, in this diagram here on line conductor, we call it as phase conductor. It is touching the earth mass or it is touching the earth conductor, protective earth conductor. So what will happen? Earth fault will happen. So due to this earth fault, some heavy fault current will be passing through that loop and the OCPD overcurrent protective device may trip. Let us see what will happen, how fast OCPD will work. It is actually depending upon the fault current, is it? The fault current will be decided by the value of loop impedance. Means that loop will have an impedance. So what are the components of that impedance, or what are the components of that loop? Here you can see one protective conductor, protective earth conductor. Then earth mass will be there because it is passing through the earth and returning to neutral, then winding, then this phase conductor or line conductor. So these components will determine the value of the impedance. So that loop will have an impedance and it will decide the value of the OC, value of the fault current, and depending upon the value of the fault current, this OCPD will trip. If the fault current is high, OCPD will trip faster, is it? So let us see what is the explanation as per our standards about this fault loop impedance. As per 3043, it is the impedance of the earth fault current loop, or we call it as phase to earth loop, starting and ending at the point of earth fault. Suppose here the earth fault point is here. The earth fault is happened at that point. So that is the starting point, and it is coming like this and ending there also. So the starting and ending of the earth fault point will determine, will give us a loop. The impedance of that loop is called earth fault loop impedance. And about the components of the loop, in 732 it is given that the circuit protective conductor, I told you about this protective conductor, then consumer's earthing terminal, because through earth it is passing, so the earthing terminal will have some role, and it is in TN system, because in TN system actually we are giving a separate protective conductor. Actually the earth mass will not come into picture. So in TN, that we will study later. In TN system, the protective conductor will be another component in earth fault loop impedance. Then in TT and IT system, earth mass will come. Anyway, leave that point, we will study it later. Okay. Then about path through the earth neutral point, here it is, neutral conductor. Then transformer winding, then the line conductor. So the components of the loop I explained, and it is as per 732, and that loop will have an impedance. That impedance is called as earth fault loop impedance, and depending upon the value of the loop impedance, the looping current may vary, and depending upon that value, the OCPD will trip. So here I am telling one point in advance. For this TT and IT system, the role of earth mass will come, because there will not be a direct conductor for earthing. But in TN system, the source from the source we are giving a separate conductor for earthing. So and it is called as protective earthing. So the earth mass will not come into picture. So the loop impedance will be less in case of TN system than TT and IT. So the loop impedance will be lower in case of TN system, and the fault current, earth fault current will be high, and the OCPD will work faster. Anyway, we will study it later in deep. Okay. Now let us see what is main earthing terminal or MET. For explanation of MET, from figure 31 of IS 3043, the earthing arrangement and protective conductors are shown. You please note the numbers from 1, 2 and 3. So this one, then suppose on M means we can say it as an equipment or a motor. So that motor will have an enclosure. So that enclosure, we can say it as exposed conductive parts of the equipment. So that must be earthed in duplicate, that is shown in this diagram. Okay, then another one, C, it is shown as extraneous conductive parts. Extraneous means it may not be an equipment, but it is a metal piece in the vicinity of our wiring. So that is just like a grill or something like that. If it is near the our wiring, it is better to connect this metal piece into that earthing system. That is shown here. Then P is incoming metallic service. Means let it be gas service. So that metal pipe also should be connected to this system. So we are doing the process of equipotential bonding. I explained in the last video, we are doing equipotential bonding, and for this bonding we are interconnecting the earthing conductor or the protective conductor using a main earthing terminal, or we call it as MET, or we can say we know about earth bus. So just like a bus, so main earthing terminal means it is interconnecting all the earth components. That is what is the duty of main earthing terminal. Okay, you please note two earth electrodes also here. Now let us see what is MET as per our standard 732 and 3043. See, as per 732, it is explained that MET is required for protective equipotential bonding, and the following components will be interconnected through the MET. So here you please note that functional earthing conductor is also connected to MET. It is explained both in 732 and 3043. You please note here. So functional earthing conductor, I told you about functional earthing conductor in the first video. It is the earthing for the function of that equipment. Say in the case of a CT scanner, there will be a reference point which is connected to connector for functional purpose. So that is called the functional earthing. So that functional earthing conductor also can be connected to this MET. See here, as per 732 321, what is MET? The terminal or bar which is the equipotential bonding conductor of protective conductors and conductors for functional earthing. Means MET is a common point interconnecting all these components. Then another thing, for this MET, an independent earthing conductor, earthing should be given. It is for both TN and TT and IT also. It is explained there. So I told you about this TN system, there will be protective earthing conductor, but even in addition to that protective earthing conductor, we should provide an independent earthing for this MET. And for the other case also, TT and IT also, this MET should have an independent earthing. Anyway, we will discuss in detail about MET later with the figures. Okay. Another basic point I want to tell you before entering deep into our earthing configuration, and that is about RCD, or we call it as RCCB. We know we will be giving face and neutral to this RCD, and there will not be any link or any connection with the earth. So there will be earth conductor and neutral conductor and face conductor, but we are giving only face and neutral to RCD. So what I am telling you, you please note these cross points. We should never earth, or we should never earth that neutral conductor repeatedly, or the earthing of the neutral should be done prior to that RCD, and it is done by the supplier. And the consumer should not earth this neutral conductor. If it is done so, that RCD will not work proper. But we can earth that protective earthing, any number of earth electrodes you can provide. Okay. Now let us see the notations for earthing configuration. It is represented by two or three letters. And for the utilization of electricity, we know there will be a source side and load side, or installation side. So from the source, how it is fed to the load, and how the neutral is given to load, and how earthing is given to given from source to load, that is what is explained here. And so we are having two parts, source and load. So suppose we are representing source with a letter X and equipment with Y. So the earthing configuration will be XY. And let us see what is X and Y, and what is the meaning of X. It is the configuration of neutral and earth conductors on the supply side, means the source side. In the source side, how the neutral and earth are related. And in the load side also, the same meaning is there, how neutral and earth are related, and how it is connected from the source. That is the meaning of Y. So the source will be source can be generator or transformer, and the load can be a main switchboard or some conductor load. So here X or Y can be any of these letters. X or Y can be any of the letters. See here, if it is T, what's the meaning? T is took from French, the word is terre, and its meaning is earth. So in a earthing configuration, if you are seeing it a letter T, what's the meaning? That part is earthed. Means if it is in the source side, means the source is earthed, and if it is in the load side, it is earthed. That's the meaning of T. Then neutral, N. Then I. I means just opposite to that T. T means earthed, I means isolated. It will not be earthed or unearthed. Then neutral means, you know, neutral will be earthed or some other meaning. Anyway, let it be there, that we will understand later. And some subset notations are also there. S and combined. S means separate, and C means combined. So these are the basic earthing configuration. Source side T and load side N. TN system. Then this TN system will be divided into TNC, TNCS, TNS. Means how the neutral and earth conductor is coming from the source to load. That will be discussing through this TNC, TNCS and TNS. Other than this TN system, there is TT and IT. Anyway, we will study in detail about this later. Now, the earthing configuration, first I am explaining about TN system, but that part will be taken in the next video. I hope I have completed the basic part of earthing configuration. Now we will go into a very individual earthing configurations, and we will see the pictures there. I hope this information was useful for you. Please share this information with your friends also. See, it is an important information actually for this practicing engineers or practicing technicians. They must know what is earthing configuration. So kindly share with our friends, and kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, support me. We will see through another video. Thank you for your kind patience in listening this video. We will see later. Thank you.